And then I hope we guys have learned one or two things from the presentation. I will be around in the presentation when the section for question and answers come. If there's anything that will require my input, I'm actually available to answer you guys. I am in the Telegram group as well. You can just contact me anytime if you have anything. And Zena is a close friend of mine. If you need anything, maybe through him or through me directly, we can all support each other. So thank you very much, guys. As Vincent said, we'll attend to question and answers after the entire presentation. So just jot down your questions and keep them ready for me. I'll come back to answer all the questions. Thank you so much, Vincent, and you can take over now.
Okay, thank you so much, Sally. I'm very much happy with your presentation. You are a tutor in making.
I'm not
bad. Okay, that's very much okay. I really appreciate, and I wish we continue supporting all the OSCE candidates so that they have the best experience in their undertaking.
Thank you, sir.
Now, I'll take you through the new OSCE for the planning and the for planning and evaluation session. It's for the planning, it is similar with what Sally has just provided. The difference is there is no part of patient self-care activities. Sorry a bit, I'll be admitting other people as we go along, so you will see me always also checking onto the camera. So for the planning of the new OSCE, As Sally said, this is where you will be provided with all that you had done earlier on in your assessments, and you are supposed to identify two problems. So for this scenario, I've considered a patient with depression, that is a PHQ-9 patient, and you identify two problems that you are going to concentrate on in your planning. And you need to be very fast, because with the new OSCE, planning takes only 14 minutes. To mean you have to write your problem statement 1 and problem statement 2 within around 6 minutes and have 6 minutes each and have 1 minute to check all that you are doing. Now, for this case, for the nursing problem, if the patient is a depressed patient, then your priority would be depression or low mood, whichever one you like. So maybe this patient had lost a loved one or a pet, something, the patient is grieving. So I would say that my patient is David, and David is experiencing low mood due to grieving, as evidenced by patient healthcare questionnaire score of 16, that is PHQ-9. And in the first statement, you are supposed to give it in full without abbreviating it. Subsequently, you might abbreviate it, but the initial one, you have to give it in full. Then the aim of care is what you are opting to do. PHQ-9 is just a score of which you will have had the score pre-filled and all that. So your aim of care would be to reduce it. So I'll say that David will have an improved mood, or David will have a PHQ-9 score of less than what is provided, which is 16, following nursing intervention. The re-evaluation date will depend. If the patient is in a nursing home, you will just stay to be evaluated every 4 hours, or more frequently if the condition changes. Now, the care provided by the nurses will be similar with what Sally provided. You will follow hematuria. Explain and discuss all aspects of care and gain consent. That's very essential. You are supposed to monitor and record the vital signs every 4 hours and escalate to the nurse in charge. Then for this case, assess the psychological status using the PHQ-9 weekly or as advised by the mental health team. You are supposed also to teach Jenny on diversionary activities that would help in improving the mood. Administer prescribed medications, refer Jenny to mental health team. instruct on proper use of call bell and place within reach, then document all cares as planned. With that one, you are done with the ematarid. And remember, your aim is have five points, that is explain, monitor, administer medication as prescribed, instruct on proper use of call bell, document all cares planned. The five are common to all other cases. Then have three specific to the problem. If it is low mood, I'll teach diversion reactivities. I'll refer to mental health team, okay, and maybe involve the family in the patient's care so that it can elevate their mood. Then again, you go now to the second problem you are having. And for my case, depending on the problem you identified during assessment, I determined that David is having issues with their meals, a low appetite, and poor nutrition. So my second problem here would be low appetite. So I'll say David is having low appetite due to depression, as evidenced by PHQ-9 of 16. So if it is a depressed patient, then the evidence have to be PHQ-9 in both cases, okay? Then aim of care would be Jenny will have improved appetite, okay? And will have PHQ-9 score of less than 16, what is provided. You have to mention the PHQ-9. This applies to both MUST, PHQ-9, and also GCS score. Those scores, you have to place them in aim of care at all times. That's the difference between news and these other elements. And for the new OSCE, remember we are using the news chart except the GCS score alone. We will come on to that as we go along. So my aim of care, I've said David will have improved appetite and also have a PHQ-9 score of less than 16, to be reevaluated today every 4 hours or more frequently if the condition changes. With that one, I'm now able to move to the care provided by the nurses. And the care provided by the nurses, I follow the ematarid, and now my focus is on low appetite, but remember I'm handling PHQ-9 patient. So in my E, I'll have explain and discuss all aspects of care. Monitor and record vital signs every 4 hourly and escalate to the nurse in charge as required. Then I'll have assess Jennifer's psychological status using PHQ-9 weekly or as advised by the mental health team. Okay, administer prescribed medication and check their effectiveness. Okay, then now I have my three specific points in relation to loss of appetite. I would advise David to take small frequent diets so that to encourage feeding. I would also refer David to dietitian so that he can be assessed and assisted. At the same time, I would encourage David to take food of their preference so that to improve their intake, then instruct on proper use of call bell, then document all cares up as planned. As you can see, this planning is similar with the old OSCE. The difference is we don't have patient self-care activities. When I'm done with that one, you print your name, write them in capital letters, your name, then place the signature and date. And with that one, you are done with the planning. The difference between the old OSCE and the new OSCE for planning is only the patient self-care activities, which are not available for the new OSCE. So consider that one at all times. With that one, are you guys happy for the new OSCE planning?